Ugh. Steelers. Basically, this was an even game, plus 110 on the money line. Broncos, 1.5, you see there. So Pittsburgh covered on the money line and on the spread. And the under, this was a game that, you know, it was pretty close to the number you see there. So there you have yourself a win if you're Pittsburgh. You're like, wait, we're good again? Or we just have a good day? Because Ben Roethlisberger, is he good again? Or did they just have a good day? Then you have the Broncos and the Steelers. Yeah. Your team, your old group, they got it done today. Mm. What did the Steelers show you today, taking care of the Broncos and dismissing them at Heinz?
Offensively, if the offensive line just goes out and do what they're supposed to do, they're a competitive team. I mean, Big Ben today had a real good day, over 250 yards, two touchdowns. We saw splash plays coming from his arm. Many people felt like, well, his arm is dead. The strength is no longer there. No, it's still there. He just needs time. And one thing I can say about Big Ben, guys, he felt comfortable being behind the offensive line. It was almost like for the very first time this season, he trusted that they can get their job done and he can go through his progressions. And outside of throwing the football, guess what? We saw Najee Harris sighting, not catching the football, but running the football, over 100 yards on the ground. Clearly, the offensive line was a difference maker today.
Denver, we know that they are the Kings in New York, or at least New Jersey, where because they beat the Giants and the Jets, go 3-0. But they're sort of the bums of the AFC North. They lose to Baltimore. They lose to Pittsburgh. Who's Denver?
Mm. They're a pretender. And I thought that when they were 3-0, and oh, you're the worst 3-0 team in the NFL, there was something a little bit to that. They were tested by the Baltimore Ravens and failed that test. Now, they've been tested by the Pittsburgh Steelers and ailing a Pittsburgh Steelers team that was on the ropes. They failed that test again. And yeah, Teddy Bridgewater, who was in the concussion protocol for all this week, didn't really get that much practice with the team. Not surprised that the offense came out a little flat, 2-for-12 on third downs. I picked the Steelers in this game, but I have wanted the Denver Broncos to perform better against better talent. They have yet to do that. And again, we're talking about the easiest division in football just a little bit ago with the AFC South, the toughest division in football in the AFC West. I don't know who's going to win the AFC West, but I feel pretty comfortable saying that the Denver Broncos, here with an above 500 record, is the worst team in the AFC West.
Yep, they're trying, and it's been a long time since they won that Super Bowl, Peyton Manning, back in 2015.
Do you want a sports network that delivers everything that matters about the game? The highlights, the picks, the instant analysis. No yelling, no fake debates, no politics. Hit the subscribe button and never miss a moment.